Hi everyone and welcome back. And in this video we are going to talk about the different possible ways to manage the React state. So till now we have covered the function component, class based component. We talked about how to initialize the state in the classes, how to create a state object inside a functional component using hooks. But is it a right way to create a state in each and every component? Because when you are changing the state, the reconciliation process happening and the re-rendering is happening for the component. So updating the state, unnecessary updating the state will also increase the cost of your rendering. If your components are complex, having many child component and you are updating the state and you are unnecessary rendering all your child component, then it will always be a trouble because your component will re-render. You will not be able to see it, but your application will not be that much performant. If you are doing a lot of things in child component, like making an API call based on the state update. Okay, so what is the right way to do all these things? Okay, here we are just going to talk very general, not in terms of code. Okay, and I will not also say that just use Redux to manage the state of your application, but that can be one possibility. Currently what is happening is, this is the current structure we have created till today, is we are writing the parent component, child component, grandchild component, and whenever the state is getting changed, what is happening is all the child components are getting re-rendered because we don't override should component update to prevent the re-rendering of component. Okay, so in this hierarchical structure we are actually triggering the event, changing the state from the triggering the event, and based on that event we are changing the state of the parent component. Parent component state is getting changed, it will re-render all your child components. Okay, so with few set of components this approach is fine. You can use the constructor based state initialization in the parent component or hooks in the functional component, things are good. But your component state grows, right? You have a very complex application, banking, finance, healthcare, any kind of application where you need to manage the data of the user across different components. Then you can't keep passing that data from one component to another component. You have to have some kind of a store. Consider that I have some data here in this node and I want that data to be available here. User profile information I fetched here, but I need that information here. In that case, we are not able to do it. Either you pass that data, make it available to the topmost component, and topmost component will pass it as a props to the child components. Okay, so this is called cascade update will happen if you are just doing this thing. But what is the other option to manage this kind of a global state where any component can access any kind of state object and can update the state? So that is called store. Okay, we can have isolated store where each and every component can go and talk to the store. Okay, give me this state, give me that state, or just I'm sending you this action, please update this particular state, and whenever the state is getting updated, propagate this change to all the components. That will come into this framework Redux, but this approach will actually reduce the complexity of the state updates and unnecessary re-rendering of component. Here we created a store, inside that store we will actually manage the store state of the application. Like in the shopping cart application, what can be state? The items, the product information which you added in the cart, the price which you need to pay, and the quantity of each and every item. That can be the state of your whole application. Now when you are adding, removing the product from the cart or adding new cart, then you will be just updating this global store. Okay, add new item. Okay, let's add one more item in your cart object, remove item from the cart object, update the total which you need to pay. That you will be doing in the global state, and every component can access that information anywhere in the whole tree, right? So that is the advantage. Here we don't need to pass this props and state from child to parent to grandchild, or we are not doing this kind of unnecessary calculation of the state from any component. Okay, so we have centralized the state inside a store, and that store is managing everything now. Okay, so this is called Redux implementation. Same thing we can achieve using useContext hook or useContext producer consumer concept. So useContext gives us a globalization of some data at the parent level in the provider, and we can create a consumers at the child component level who can consume the state at any level. You don't need to do a props drilling where you are passing the props data from parent to child to grandchild and then grandchild is receiving it. You can create a provider at the top level and consumer at any child level. Consumer can directly access whatever you have set in the providers. You can create multiple providers. That is another implementation. So you can use a context APIs, you can use use reducer and use context in the functional component to manage the state for the small application, or you can use Redux for the class-based component, or at the parent level component use some kind of a global store, and that store you can have inside your provider, and at the child level you just create a consumers. Many options, right? The default is just have a class-based state, or at the parent level you create a context as a provider. At the child component, you create a consumer. It can be like your functional component or a class-based component. It is supported both. You can create a context at the parent level and create a consumer at the child components. In terms of hooks, we are using useContext hook to consume the data at the child component. Okay, but broadly there are 3-4 possible ways. Either use Redux, option one. Either use useContext or use reducer hook in functional component. Option three, use context APIs in the class-based component, put things inside a global store in the global provider, create consumer providers at your child components, okay? Or use mbox. There are other frameworks are also available which are providing same kind of implementation which Redux is providing. So that is another way, okay? So Redux somewhat look like this. From React component, you are triggering actions, and then you are updating, this action is going to the store. Store will take care of giving you the new state object based on the action you have triggered. So like you have triggered action increment. So increment will increase the state from 1 to 2 and the new state will be returned to your React component. Okay, so React component will consume the updated state from the store. So store is a global store outside. You are dispatching action, updating the store, and this store will return the new state. New state will be consumed by the UI again. Okay, same life cycle. Now, what we will talk about two different approaches in the coming set of videos. First is using useContext APIs. useContext is a hook name for functional component. Context API is something for the class-based component. But both are doing the same thing. If you are writing functional component, then you will use useContext hook. Or if you are writing classes, then you will use context.provider and consumer. Okay, this is the one thing, and another thing is the Redux. Redux is most popular for managing the state. So we will talk about Redux and this context, and we'll see how we can make the combination. And another smaller combination which you can think of using is combine use context and use reducer hooks for functional component. That will give you a lot of relief in terms of managing the component level store. Okay. Thanks everyone, and in the coming set of videos we will talk about useContext and Redux framework, how to manage the state of the components.